tag team action as the Jackals, Recon, and Sniper take on Blackjack Bradshaw and Windham, the new Blackjacks.
But first, grab your pen and piece of paper because here comes information on how you can win Stone Cold's truck.
You can't walk his walk.
And I know that better than anybody.
You can't talk his talk.
My mouth is starting to get wet already.
But you can drive the truck. The Stone Cold Steve Austin specially equipped Chevy Z71 pickup. Because we're giving it away in the WWF Royal Rumble sweepstakes. To enter, call 1-900-RUMBLE-98. It's $1.99 per call, and there's no purchase or telephone call necessary to enter. Simply handprint your name, address, and telephone number on a standard-sized postcard and send it to the address on your screen. You must be 18 and have a valid driver's license to enter. Deadlines for entries is Monday, January 12th. But don't delay. Call 1-900-RUMBLE-98 and enter now. The call costs $1.99. 20 runners up will receive a Royal Rumble merchandise gift pack valued at $250. Winners will be selected at random and announced during the Royal Rumble, January 18th on pay-per-view.
Watch as Strider.
Welcome back to Shotgun, Michael Cole and Kevin Kelly. The Truth Commission heading to the ring for a matchup. My New Year's resolution to win that Stone Cold truck.
Yeah, good luck. I understand you're wearing out the phone at your house.
Accompanied by the Jackal at a total combined weight of 556 pounds, Recon Sniper, the Truth Commission.
The Jackal, the leader of the Truth Commission.
I'll tell you what, I'm Catholic. We have Ash Wednesday. I don't think that's anything like that. It's a lot more sinister, I think.
Recon and Sniper from the Truth Commission set for action, tag team action this week. Of course, led by the Jackal, once again placing a bead on a member of the audience. I guess it's a bead.
Well, I'm interested in the symbolism of what that exactly means. Perhaps we'll have the opportunity to speak to the Jackal about this. Sir, if you don't mind.
We're hoping to get a word with the Jackal as Recon and Sniper get set for action this week against the new Blackjacks.
This is going to be a war.
Coming down the aisle from the state of Texas at a total combined weight of 582 pounds, Windham and Bradshaw, the new Blackjacks.
We're joined now at ringside by the Jackal. And first off, Mr. Jackal, thanks for joining us. The question we had, we were discussing the how you place, I guess it's a bead under the forehead of a member of the audience. You did it last week and now again this week. What is the symbolism of that?
I find a young, worthy female in the audience, and you know, with me, it's all about intellectual intercourse, and we know that it feels good because I have got the biggest mind in the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, Jackal, be that as it may, with your innuendo and all, how would you rate this matchup with Recon and Sniper going after the new Blackjacks? Certainly two very even teams.
You know, I'm not some throwback to the 1970s. I'm not going to sit out here and tell you that the Blackjacks are a bad tag team or anything like that. Quite to the contrary, Blackjack Bradshaw, probably one of the toughest men in the World Wrestling Federation today. And, of course, Blackjack Windham, his credentials speak for themselves. They're a fabulous tag team. It's a great test for Recon and Sniper.
Blackjack Windham, of course, starting action off against Recon as usual. The Truth Commission impressive as of late. Recon now backs Blackjack Bradshaw into the ropes. Off the ropes now, big takedown by the 6'8" Blackjack Bradshaw.
We're talking about four big men, which brings me to an event that's coming up, the annual Royal Rumble.
That's right, January 18th.
And I said that I would come forth with another revelation. My revelation is something that is going to shock the world, and that is that a man is coming to the Royal Rumble. He is the biggest man on the planet. He is the biggest, most insane individual in the World Wrestling Federation, and he is none other than Kurgan, gentlemen, in the Royal Rumble.
He will be a part of the Royal Rumble January 18th
in San Jose. To quote a little bit of Latin, Malleus Maleficorum, the hammer of evil doing is coming.
Speak of hammering, Justin Bradshaw now hammering away at Recon.
Yeah, some evil doing as well. A big chop and a boot to the corner.
And there's the big boot now to the face of Recon. Bradshaw in control. Whips Recon. Oh, look at this. What power from Blackjack Bradshaw.
Where is Kurgan this week? Conspicuous by his absence.
Kurgan is always nearby. He is a man who is here to do my bidding. You see, I'm the political arm of the Truth Commission, and sometimes I need to drop the hammer. And tonight, the hammer may drop this week, and it may not.
Well, the Blackjacks are really taking it to your team so far. Are you in the least bit concerned?
Look out now, Windham with a big drop kick.
You know what? It doesn't concern me whatsoever.
Here's a quick
because
cover.
These men are willing to do anything to make me happy. I really don't care if Recon here gets injured in this match or not. What I care about is that they're out there making the money for this big tag team match and doing my bidding.
Blackjack Windham with a big power move that time. Excuse me, Kevin, as he slams Recon into the center of the ring. Recon really needs to make a tag here.
Recon is a guy who came to me 3 months ago and told me that all he wanted was to be a star, and he'd be willing to do anything to accomplish that.
There's a cover now. There's two.
And this is all part of it, laying your life, if necessary, on the line.
Talk about your spirituality, if you can, for a moment. Where exactly did you go to some kind of theology school? Were you schooled in some kind of ministerial training?
Kevin Kelly, I've stated before, I don't wish to talk about the man that I was. I like to talk about the man that I have become.
Here's a cover now by Bradshaw. There's two, but Recon slips out.
Quite clearly, I am the most intelligent man in the World Wrestling Federation. Quite clearly, I'm capable of doing any job in the World Wrestling Federation, including yours, if I so see fit.
Blackjack Bradshaw now whips Recon across the ring. There's the big boot. Recon is in trouble.
Boy, Recon has been just taking a beating, Michael, from the opening bell, unable to even make one tag.
The Blackjack's in control. Now Recon into the big boot of Blackjack Windham. And here comes the veteran of the Blackjacks. Windham, of course, the son of former WWF Tag Team Champion Blackjack Mulligan.
Barry Windham is a phenomenal athlete for a man that size. Unbelievable.
Only one that time. Speaking to Mr. Kurgan, we were talking about him before, Kurgan the interrogator. What is the symbolism, I guess, the way you control the man with that evil slap?
It's not an evil slap whatsoever. I have a way of getting my message across to Kurgan. He's clearly a man of few words. The only hold I have over Kurgan is that everything I promised him has come to pass.
Here's a cover now by Windham, only two before Sniper kicks out.
Certainly the new Blackjacks, fresh off a tour of Japan, which was an enormous success, are looking tremendous here this week on Shotgun, and some tense looks on the faces of Rico Sniper.
I know that you and the rest of the announcers in the World Wrestling Federation would like to put a gag on me, but let me tell you something. Life is an incurable disease, and so am I, as far as the WWF is concerned.
High impact move there. Now the cover, two, but Windham kicks out. Folks, the Raw magazine hit the stands this week. A tremendous demand for both Sonny and Sable on their own unique covers of the Raw magazine, which is now monthly. And following the embarrassing situation perpetrated by Marvelous Mark Mero, he and Tom Brandy will battle one-on-one this week on Raw, and I'm sure Sable will be a very interested partner.
I must admit that since you did take over control of this team, they've showed a much more aggressive attitude in the ring. But that time, Windham makes the tag now to Bradshaw. And look out, here comes the big man from Texas. Big right hand.
Whoa.
Sniper off the apron of the ring. Bradshaw now in control of Recon. Whips him across the ring. The big drop kick.
Perhaps no tougher man, pound for pound, though, in the World Wrestling Federation, Blackjack Bradshaw.
Look at the punishment that Recon is willing to take to make him happy.
How much more of this can he take?
Bradshaw. As much as he needs to.
Bradshaw now off the ropes. Here he comes. Oh,
it's hilarious. That's it.
This should be it. It's over. Here's the cover. What a save by Sniper. Now all four men are in the ring.
Not for long, though.
Double team upcoming now by the new Blackjacks. Your man is in trouble, Mr. Jackal. Oh, no, there goes the Jackal. Here's the double team. This one should be over. Where's he going?
He's going right in.
No. And look what's coming down the ramp. Kurgan. Kurgan the interrogator, the 7-foot, 350-pound monster, heading to the ring.
Jackal's best offensive weapon right now could be his tennis shoes. He needs to get on his bicycle. Watch out from behind.
Look out now. Oh, no. Bradshaw tried to take control of Kurgan. He was hit by Sniper from behind.
Look at this man.
The paralyzer. Kurgan has the paralyzer on Blackjack Windham.
A page in the legend of the Blackjacks is the claw. But perhaps no version of the claw is more devastating than the paralyzer. And Windham may perish at Kurgan's hand.
The Jackal trying to get Kurgan off Blackjack Windham. What's going to happen if Kurgan the interrogator clamps the paralyzer on any one of the 29 other superstars who will be involved in the Royal Rumble? Jackal, the only one.
I think Jackal is going to unleash Kurgan at the Royal Rumble in 2 weeks on pay-per-view. And no matter whether it's Steve Austin, Ken Shamrock, anybody, it could be a long night with Kurgan involved.
The new Blackjacks victorious as the result of the disqualification. What a battle with the Truth Commission. Jackal leading the troops back to the the locker room area. Folks, let's head down to Slam Jam. Here's Doc Hendricks.